rocket against the gravitational force of attraction. So propellant is the chemical substance, okay, so that will undergo combustion to produce pressurized gases whose energy is, it will give a pressurized gas. So that energy will be utilized to move a rocket against the gravitational pull, to move the rocket against the gravitational force of attraction, okay. So it is a mixture which contains a fuel that burns and an oxidizer. So it is a mixture which will consist of a fuel and the oxidizer, which supplies the oxygen necessary for the burning of the fuel. So it will supply the oxygen which is necessary for the burning of the fuel. The propellant may be in the form of a solid or liquid. So that will be, it will be in the form of solid or liquid, okay. So what is propellant? It is a chemical substance that will undergo combustion to produce pressurized gas whose energy is utilized to move a rocket against the gravitational force of attraction, okay. So first let's see about liquid propulsion, okay. So in liquid propellants, fuels and oxidizer are combined in the combustion chamber where they burn and come out from the base of the rocket with a great force. So in the liquid propellant, the oxidizer and the liquid propellant fluids will be combined, okay, it will be combined so that they will burn and come out of the base of the rocket, that is at bottom of the rocket with a great force. So with that great force only the rocket will move, okay. So liquid hydrogen, hydrazine and ethyl alcohol are the liquid fuels. So the liquid fuels are liquid hydrogen, hydrazine and ethyl alcohol, okay. So some of the oxidizers are oxygen, ozone, hydrogen peroxide and fuming nitric acid. So these are all the oxidizers. So the oxidizer and the liquid propellant which is in the combustion chamber will be combined so that they will burn and come out from the base of the rocket with a great force, okay. Yes, so see, this is the liquid hydrogen, this is liquid hydrogen and this is the fuming nitric acid, okay. Yes, so next let's see about solid propellants. So in solid rockets, propellants, fuels and oxidizer compounds are already combined. So in solid rocket, the solid rocket fuels and the oxidizer will be already combined, okay. But in liquid propellants, they should be combined in the combustion chamber, okay. So but in solid propellants, they will be already in the combined compounds only, okay. The what will be combined? The solid rocket propellants fuels and the oxidizer compounds, okay. So when they are ignited, they burn and produce heat energy. So when they are ignited, they will be burn and they will produce energy. So the combustion of solid propellants cannot be stopped once it is ignited. So the combustion of solid propellants will not be stopped once it is ignited. So once when it is ignited, there will not be any stop in the combustion of solid propellants, okay. So solid fuels used in the rockets are polyurethanes and polybutadienes. So these are the fuels which used in rockets, which is polyurethanes and polybutadienes, okay. So the nitrate and chlorate salts are used as oxidizer. So the oxidizer is nitrate and chlorate and the solid fuels in polyurethane and polybutane. So these two fuels and oxidizer will already in the combined state only, okay. So when they are ignited, they will start burn and they will produce heat energy. So once when they are ignited, they cannot be stopped, okay. Yes, so see, this is the polyurethanes and this is polybutadienes, okay. Yes, so next let's see about cryogenic propellants, okay. So cryogenic propellants, in this type of fuel, the fuel or oxidizer are both are liquefied gases and they are stored at a very low temperature. So these both are in the liquefied gases, okay. So they will be in the liquefied gases, which are stored at a very low temperature, okay. So these fuels do not need any ignition system, okay. So like solid propellants, in cryogenic propellants, the fuels do not need any ignition system, okay. So the